Legislators on the Committee of Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises COSACE have expressed concern over the low reproduction among some animals kept in Entebbe Zoo. Yet taxpayers' money is used in feeding, treating and offering security to these animals. The concern was raised by the chairperson of the committee, Medad Segona, the Busoro East County Member of Parliament, who wondered why the population of rhinos at the Uganda Wildlife Education Center remains at 2, yet they have a female and a male.
My view is this, I think, for making progress.
Yes.
One, that you stick to the Serenity Prayer. You know what it says? God, give me the serenity to change things I can change and to accept those I cannot change.
This was during an interaction with COSACE yesterday regarding the Auditor General's report on the entity. James Musinguzi, the Executive Director UWEC, attributed the failure of the two rhinos to reproduce in the environment they are being raised, saying this has forced them to look at each other as siblings. He however noted that some research has been done in other countries.
It has succeeded in other countries. Countries like South Africa, they have done very well in Kruger National Park, using that multi-pronged approach. We have countries, even Malawi has tried.
The officials also raised concern over the dropping number of lions, which needs immediate intervention.
Especially in Chidepo. Chidepo National Park had quite a number of lions, but right now there must be less than even 15 or 10.
MPs accused of embezzling cooperative cash were at the anti-corruption court in Kampala yesterday for a bail application before Magistrate Joan Akiro. The MPs, Michael Mawanda, Ignatius Mudimiwa Makuyu and Paula Kamba, appeared before lawyer Julius Kiria and Leonard Kavondi, the other principal cooperative officer at the Ministry of Trade, Industry and Cooperatives. Prosecution, led by Adina Simwe, said they were ready to present evidence against the accused as investigations are complete.
Prosecution, in the last appearance, informed court that inquiries are complete. For purposes of disclosure, prosecution would be comfortable to disclose the persons who counsel after receiving official communication.
However, the defense team requested bail for their clients, saying they are members of parliament and are reputable.
And all other accused persons deferred their right to apply for bail.
Your Worship, the applicant before you is a member of parliament representing the people of Elgon County.
They presented documents pertaining to the accused and their sureties.
We tendered the land paper in terms of Honorable Mawanda, the Southern Incumbents, mortgage.
However, prosecution requested time to scrutinize the documents before the accused are granted bail.
Rule 7. Which we are sure we cannot comfortably say we have done all the background checks, and we are sure, given the short time we have received these documents in court.
JJ Kiro granted the request, deferring the case until July 18th. NATO leaders will meet today for their 75th anniversary, seeking ways to revamp up support for Ukraine as deadly Russian strikes and political uncertainties in the West stir new concerns. Kicking off 3 days of event for the 32-nation alliance with a celebration yesterday, President Joe Biden announced a new air defense system for Kyiv and urged unity against Russian President Vladimir Putin, who launched the Ukraine invasion in 2022.
Remember, NATO's character is fundamentally democratic, always has been and always must continue to be. And today, NATO is better resourced than it ever has been. Ukraine can and will stop Putin. Especially with our full collective support. They have our full support.
But the U.S. president himself is facing a tough election challenge from Donald Trump, who has loudly questioned the utility of NATO and mused on forcing a peace deal in which Ukraine would surrender land to Russia. Zelensky in Washington thanked Ukraine's backers for the promise of new air defenses and urged the United States and others to go further to help defeat Russia.
First of all, America, and first of all, the leaders of America, and the President of the United States as a leader of the free world, to be uncompromising in defending democracy, uncompromising against Putin and his coterie, uncompromising to every possible terror.
NATO's outgoing Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg of Norway acknowledged the question marks after Trump's allies in the U.S. Congress forced a delay of months in approving new weapons for Ukraine.
So in this 75th anniversary of our alliance, we can finally say that NATO is not only the most successful and the strongest, but also the longest lasting alliance in history.
Other leaders attending the summit include Hungarian Prime Minister Viktor Orban, one of Putin's closest partners in the West, who ahead of Washington went to Ukraine, Russia, and China on a self-described peace mission.